Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Mornings on Horseback, the story of an extraordinary family, a vanished way of life, and the unique child who became Theodore Roosevelt, book by David McCulloch. This was a thorough and well-written storyline of the basis of the Long Island Roosevelt branch. McCulloch always takes you into places you would not normally go with regard to character development. For those who are studying or are just interested in American history, this is a great secondary source that brings Theodore Roosevelt, Jr. McCulloch describes at great length the many times T.R. was out west, probably the most tedious part of the book. A perfect book to understand Theodore Roosevelt, and especially before visiting the Theodore Roosevelt National Park. His devotion to research is admirable, as is his remarkable ability to tell the story. He is seriously overlooked in our day, but it is clear why Guts and Borlum include a TR on Mount Rushmore. As always, McCulloch's writing is riveting, his research is rigorous, and his analysis is flawless. The book covers the early life of Theodore Roosevelt, and suggests the ethos of the country at that time. It's not an especially quick read because of all the detail, but it's worth the effort to get to know one of our greatest presidents. Hunting, dancing, reading, and traveling were the kinds of activities and habits that molded young Teddy into the man who would remember it a century after his death. It is a little slower than a few others by McCulloch, but worth the time. This book was not especially about, rather a window into a family's life in the late 1800s, and a look at a slice of the times, and what was happening all over the country, and the world. However, that is at least partly due to the fact that Theodore Roosevelt was the best president the U.S. Teddy, as a young child, faced severe asthma, and a family that was both loving and demanding. You sit in the house with the Roosevelts, you ride down the road with them. To most people, Theodore Roosevelt was a confident and robust man of action, but Mr. It is also the story of father who passed on to his son the sense and obligation of public service despite the blessings of a wealthy and privileged upbringing. The story ends before Roosevelt becomes president, but from the beginning of the book up to the end is a joy and inspiration that a single purpose of mind can overcome seemingly impossible obstacles in one's life. These opening chapters bring into focus the complex, charming nest that hatched such a peculiar, dynamic president. When Teddy leaves Manhattan for Harvard and, later, a budding political career, the book loses momentum. Anyone who's read enough 19th century history knows that era's political conventions are fatally boring, page after page of bargaining, politicking, and negotiation. McCulloch tries his very best, but is unable to add much color to the convention's blandness. The man rode horses across the steppe, speculated on cattle, dealt with scofflaws, and nearly found himself drawn into a duel with a local kingpin and sharpshooter, mind you. McCulloch brings a fascinating era to life, and makes the reader a part-time resident for 360 wonderful pages. If the reader is interested in Teddy Roosevelt's heritage and his early personality, this is the book. Gave a real insight to who exactly was Teddy Roosevelt out of the public eye. He captures the culture the young man grew up in with all of its conflicts and social structures. A bit long on the details, occasionally asthma, but far and away a great read. More people should read this and learn to do something similar on their own, as opposed to awaiting others to subsidize their lives. This is a fabulous book. If you're a fan of Teddy Roosevelt, this is a must-read. Anecdotes abound, providing a fly-on-the-wall view of a very wealthy family at the fin de siècle which launched the Roosevelt era. Extremely well written, this is a biography that reads like a good novel, keeping you on the edge of your seat as you peer behind the costly damask draperies into the living area of a family of consequence. As you accompany the young Roosevelt to college, and trace the makings of one of the keener minds of the 20th century, the way things worked during the turn of the 20th century is most interesting as well as enlightening. From politics to the social and recreational world, a light is shown on the way things were for the wealthy. Also, the interactions between the Southern family of his mother and the Yankee family of his father are fascinating. Good read if you are looking for a little more information on history during this time frame and Theodore Roosevelt. The first several chapters cover so much detail about the source of Theodore Roosevelt's sicknesses, endurance, and strength to overcome, that it's almost too much and somewhat pedantic. It is the story of a remarkable little boy, seriously handicapped by recurrent and near-fatal attacks of asthma, and his struggle to manhood. The book shows how a sickly boy evolved into a man that became capable of being the President of the United States. This is a very well-written history of Teddy Roosevelt's family background, his parents and siblings, his upbringing and education, and the development of his career. McCulloch has a gift of writing history so interestingly that you think you are reading a novel. A superbly written study of an exceptional man, scientist, warrior, scholar, and president, Teddy Roosevelt. McCulloch is an excellent historian who is very adept at personally introducing you to his characters. This is an extraordinary book in terms of the research involved and the excellent writing. McCulloch makes excellent use of primary source material to set Theodore Roosevelt in the context of his family. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.